Okay, I'll try the try to be less personal. Okay, well, anyway, here I'm working, not working out. I'm building a. I'm remortaring, repointing. Oh my gosh, how much rock wall? A lot of rock wall. I know I enticed with my last title, but it really is a rock wall. And it's mortar and water. And I'm just using the mix kind. Now this mix, this is cheering me up oddly. It is really a torture to do. Because it's so heavy. And then there's a new thing now they use called the, it's like the cake, which you squirt the cake with, one of those cake twisters, and it squirts the, what do we call it, it's the frosting. Well, it's not frosting, it's very heavy, and it's mortar. So anyway, unfortunately, I can't really like alter it and say, okay, I'm gonna do cob now, because I'm in like this, like everything looks the same neighborhood type, which is pretty much a lot of America, and so I have to kind of match the wall that is already currently there. But yeah, it's a mean thing. So far, I've only done like maybe 8 feet by 4 feet. And it took me 2 days, and so my technique is I squirt it with this cake thing, and then I use the dabble. I use a brush, the end of a brush, after it's set a little bit, and I pounce the brush at the mortar, so it pushes it in you know, pretty flush. And then after all of that, I'm using a brush over it, and then try to brush it off the stones. And I'm not sure this mix. What's on there now? What I have now is a lot of sand, and the sand is just crumbling. It's just crumbling away. So I'm not using a sand mix. And I hope that's going to be okay. It's that regular quickcrete style in those bags. But the sand itself, those mixtures, they look like they only last like 5 years. The one that's on the wall now. And really, technically, you're supposed to take a brush and whisk the sand away. Anything that was there in the old mortar, whisk it away out of the cracks, and before you refill. But I have in my back, the back fields, sometimes they're going this deep, so you know, massive crevices, and so I have to actually even put rocks in there to fill the crevice space, because it's almost like rocks have been removed from the actual wall itself. Where the sand over the years has just drawn itself out, you know, so it's left massive crevices, and these walls are tall. They're about 6 feet, 7 feet tall, but and they weren't done all at the same time, which is annoying. It's like they do one, they had the main wall, and then later on they put a wall on top. Look at me, I cried today, I'm puffy. Oh my gosh. I hate the outburst me. I don't even outburst anymore, it's just an inward, the tears happen out, you know, it's awful. The tiered wall, yeah. Well, the second half was put in later, and the second half is all chipped, and it's got cracks in it, but it's different. It's a different wrong than the bottom half of the wall. So the bottom half of the wall, all the sand is flaked away. And I imagine it was supposed to be a sand limestone mix with cement a long time ago, or mortar, but it's flaked away. And then so now I have these stones, and they're so exposed that it's like, oh my gosh, maybe I better fix it. So that's where I'm at. And it is a chore. It's very heavy. And for some reason, the lifting of the weight, that type of a weight, it really gets like my whole body, my whole brain just like a roll, you know. So I can't do it very long. I can only maybe work the mortar maybe an hour maximum, you know. It's a very heavy chore. And then, but this top, I don't know what I'm going to do, because it was the newer one, and yet it's having cracks on the cracks are going lateral, the lateral cracks, rather than just a crack that maybe looks like an earthquake. There are a lot of these lateral ones, so it almost like it all has to be chipped off, cut away, and redone. So it's kind of an ugly chore. Anyway, and all of this, where was I? Oh yeah, I'm writing a new book. Another book. it's a poetry book, and I don't know. I'm slow at it so far. I'm on my seventh poem, I think. I'm about 30 in this book, so I don't know. I don't really feel like poetry now. You know, I get hit with all these kind of weird things, and I realized today that, you know, after 2 months of waiting for this company to arrive and just replace the object on the roof, I have, you know, I'm a pretty patient person, but, you know, and then they said today, dedicatedly, that they're here at a certain time, you know, and I'm like, yes, okay, and they're not here, and I'm like, come on. I mean, there's a point where it just becomes, you know, What cruelty streak are you on? It's tough not to take it personal. It's really tough not to take it personal. It's like it's just a direct assault, you know. And why? What would be your reason? You just fix it. And then the company itself is a major company all across the United States, the actual insurance company. And you know, I email them, and all they do is they prompt this other company to do the work. I don't know what to do, because when they weren't here at 4 o'clock, you know, I'm ready, I'm waiting, and they weren't here. You know, I just don't get it. So I found out with myself that I'm really dedicated to time frame. I'm dedicated to time frame, and I don't understand why other people aren't. You know. It's difficult to remove yourself from that and just say, well, maybe they were stuck in traffic. Well, no, instead they just caused anxiety all around this household unnecessarily. I'm throwing these out on Facebook also, because why not, you know? Why not? I don't really think I'm losing that much weight on this mono diet in the morning. I'm doing the mono diet in the morning, and then I'm on vegan the rest of the day. But I feel better, and maybe ever so often I might see the lines here of my stomach, the lat lines, ever so often they show up. So something is coming off, but it's not fast. It's not a speed diet, because there's no way I can't be on a speed diet anymore. I'm giving up. Oh, I saw beautiful, what's her name? Still is Sylvia Guillen. She's so pretty, and she was wearing her demis. She was wearing her demis on her adagio. She was the returning. Every one of her dojos, she was returning into Pase. Everyone. She wasn't doing wrong around. She was doing the front, the Ecarte style. Back, return to Pase. She wasn't holding it up and or doing all this extra torque. I don't know. I've been doing a lot of extra torque on, for some reason. I don't know what's better. I don't know what's better right now. Especially when you're older, you know, because if you're doing that extra torque around, it's like a resistance thing, you know, you're resisting out, you're resisting in all directions. But if you are keep returning, it's a much different pull, isn't it? Anyway, yeah, questions are out. And you passe or just keep doing all of those aliens and promenades. Yeah, this floor is too slippery, though, I tell you. And I'm not. I tried to put the sugar of that brown rice syrup down, and it kind of worked, but it's that sticky sound on the shoes. And it's kind of awkward, but it was kind of interesting. Because I know Coca-Cola is supposed to work. I've used that before in studios, but when I don't drink that, so I'm at this brown rice syrup. Maybe just that's an idea. Anyway, I have to get motivated to dance again, but I'm doing all of this poetry, and then writing, and then rock walling, and so. Anyway, and then I'm finding out about my hominid self, that I really am a monkey. Oh, and I saw some monkeys, and no, they are dedicated here, and they have beautiful lips. Now, these were these snub-nosed monkeys, and they're in a forest in China. They have very beautiful lips, just like ours. Well, not just, even bigger and more pronounced, but white. And very interesting. So yeah, I thought that was something else. I think there's like 700 of them left on the planet. So they only live in this one little tiny forest. And anyway. What else did I have to say in this drama distress? Luckily, my dad's feeling better after he went for a walk. I get him in a regime. He's on a walking regime. He walks quite a bit. I like to get him to walk like 2 miles at least every other day. And oh my gosh, that's been going on for almost a year. So with that, even through summer, he's been doing all of that. He's been very good, and I believe it's helping him physically continue and not be apathetic as easy and fall into a slunk. When they apathy, you know, they just get in that chair and then they can't get out. So yeah, he can still get up by himself and all those things. He can dress himself, those things. They're all very important. And I believe the exercise is pivotal. You've got to keep that walking. Sometimes he's silly and he'll even run, and then he falls down the hill sometimes. And you know, I told him don't run fast. So I'm kind of a mean, what do you call it? A mean... coach, exercise coach, but you don't want him to fall down the hill. But you know, if he's gonna do that out of full-hearted stubbornness, you know, because he thinks he can or used to be able to, that's his life. You know, he's still living his life in that way. You know, and unfortunately, he's gonna be burned by his events, and we want to protect them when they get this old. But sometimes, you know, they're gonna have to still fall. Anyway, so there, yeah. I'm on a good regime. Because there were times in California when he would not, you know, get out of bed, you know, for days. And I'm like, this is no good. This is the guy going to, you know, not out to pasture, the other, going off to the graves. So he's really stopped that. He gets up every day. And before he was like in bed maybe 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, and he wouldn't even get out of his room. So I'm really, really happy with his progress. So it just goes to show you that you can reverse, you can really try to reverse the apathy that these terrible brain diseases are trying to take over. Anyhoot. Alright guys, I'm going to sign off. Is there anything I wanted to say about hominids? I'm in love with them all. They're so wonderful. I can't believe it. I cannot believe them. They were pretty cool. Pretty dang cool.